On tonight's episode of the Mike Pressler Show, we break down the Bulldogs' big comeback win over Drexel. We sit down with senior netminder Jamison Love, and we preview this weekend's game against Albany. It's all coming up here next on the Mike Pressler Show on Cox Sports Television. And welcome to this week's episode of the Mike Pressler Show. We're here at Blackie's Bulldog Tavern in Smithfield, Rhode Island. I'm Mike Mancuso, joined as always by the head coach of the Bryant Bulldogs, Mike Pressler. And coach, comeback for the ages on Saturday against Drexel. You guys were down 5-0 late in the game. You came all the way back to win 7-6. It's your third home game, third win on the season. Doesn't get much bigger than that at that point. It's a cold day and truly a comeback for the ages. Have you ever been a part of a comeback like that in your coaching career?
I was thinking about that all weekend, you know, all the stops along the way in our career, and I can't remember ever being shut out for a half at any level, and certainly, you know, there we are with 3 minutes to go in the third, you know, we're still scoreless, so to think we were going to come all the way back, I'm not going to be a liar and say, you know, we felt that at the time, but we felt, though, if we could cut into that lead and make it a 2-3 goal game at the end of the third, and then with game on, the fact that we were winning some faceoffs and make this a one-goal game down the stretch, that certainly would have been a great accomplishment. But at the end of the day is, for us, you know, we beat arguably the best team on our schedule, or one of the top two teams on our schedule, I think. And to do it in that fashion was quite remarkable.
It certainly was. So we're going to pick up some highlights now. You guys were down 5-0 at the time.
Yeah, we're just, you know, all we needed was the first one. I said this to the guys, let's get the first one, let's get off the schneid here. Peter McMahon, again, a little room and time shot from 15 yards against a great goalie. And we kind of turned to each other on the sideline and said, hey, maybe we can do this.
Yep, that made it a 5-1 game. It was McMahon's fifth of the season.
You know, Kevin Massett going 8-for-10 on the faceoff in the second half, critical. And Matt Larson, his first goal of the season, as a defensive midfielder, right after that, the first goal, winning the faceoff, scoring again. You know, and we're all looking at each other now as we said, game on.
Yep, it was just 12 seconds between the McMahon and the Larson goal.
Here we are. Great play by Max Wiesenberg, a tip ball on extra man. He picks up a ground ball and shovels it in. So momentum all going our way at the end of the third quarter there.
Yeah, made it 5-3 at that point on Wiesenberg's sixth tally of the season.
Alex Sommerfeld kind of doing his thing and getting it started, and Peter McMahon, a very similar type of room and time shot from about 15 yards, shoots it away from his stick.
Second goal of the game for McMahon there. It came with 11:24 remaining in the fourth.
You know, right now we're all feeling this is going to go down to the wire. Be a one goal game, could go to overtime again. We do a little sub game play out of the box here, sub box, and Max gives Alex a little ground ball and split to his left hand. We started shooting low in the second half, and that certainly was key for us too.
Now perhaps the biggest play of the game.
You know, Travis Harrington dodges hard, draws a slide, room and time for Al. Little five hole right through the goal there. Ball dribbles kind of in, we'll take it. You know, one goal lead here with a little over 5 minutes to go.
Yeah, that made it 7-6 Bulldogs with 5:25 remaining in the fourth quarter. But of course, this game does not get won without the play of your senior netminder.
Yeah, we put a lot on Jay. I mean, there's no secret there. Play a little zone here down the stretch, giving them a different look. Matt McGrady, huge ground ball here, our sophomore defenseman. You know, we're under the 2 minute drill, 50 seconds to go in the game. Kind of call timeout there to get organized. Maybe called it a little too early on my part. 12 seconds to go. They do a little pick on the goal line extended. We jump switch. Matt Larson really gets up on that 43's left hand. Throws a shot at the goal with nothing much on it. And it was only fitting that Jamison made the save at the end of the game.
And there the final celebration must have felt pretty good at that point. And coach, we look at the game from an offensive perspective now. You had four different goal scorers. Three players each had two goals in McMahon, Sommerfeld, and Wiesenberg. Matt Larson also picking up his first goal this season. I knew he was coming back from an injury to start this season. It must be great to have him starting to get on an offensive role here. But what are your general thoughts on the offensive play in that game against Drexel?
You know, they were as good a defensive team as we're going to see all year with a great goalie. They're checkers. I think overall maybe they got a little bit the better of our attack in that game. But, you know, we were just very opportunistic down the stretch and, you know, made some plays in other ways, like you said, off the faceoff, you know, bounce off the extra man. You know, a couple of those things went our way to kind of get back in the game. But, you know, we got to play better. There's better lacrosse for our team moving forward. You know, we'll certainly take it. It was hot, hard fought. But the Bulldogs can certainly step up their play, and that's what our plan is this week during spring break.
Yep. Now, Jamison Love in between the pipes, 13 saves on 19 shots. He now has a .649 save percentage, second best in the entire nation. His goals against at 7.83, 11th best in the nation. Now, after allowing four goals on the first four shots that he faced, he stopped 13 of the next 15, including two in the final minute. What are your thoughts on his play in that game?
Not surprised. I think we talked about it last week's show, the matchup, Manos versus Jamison Love, and our star, two-time captain, our leader, rose to the occasion. And, you know, after that very, we would say, very disappointing first quarter on our part, giving up four, going down 4-0, Jaden really make a save in the first quarter. And Jamison is a guy that can really turn it on when he needs to. He's done that his entire career here, and not surprised at all with his play Saturday.
Now, you guys were down 5-0 after two quarters, and they seemed to get kind of a backbreaker goal there in the last minute of the second quarter. What was the message to your team, though, at the half, trailing 5-0?
We were very calm. We were very cool, collected. You know, it wasn't a lot of finger pointing or screaming and yelling. You know, the way we play, if you win face-offs, you know, you score in transition, a five-goal lead in our sport could be erased very, very quickly. And we just felt, hey, we just got to get the first one. You know, we got to tighten up defensively. No more weird ones, as we said.
Yep.
No more mental mistakes defensively. Clean that up and chip away at this lead. And that's exactly what happened. And make it a one-goal game on the stretch.
Yep.
And who would have thought that, you know, exactly happened.
Exactly. I mean, Jamison definitely seemed to be in the zone for the second half. The defense seemed to shut down the Drexel attack much better than it did in the first half. What did you like best about the defensive play, and did you feel that anyone stepped up that you maybe weren't expecting on the defensive end?
You know, I would say, you know, as a unit, we continue to improve. We got to avoid some of this, the mental breakdowns that we had at times. You know, we had a bunch of exchanges, picks, and that we usually switch. We didn't switch those. Two guys went to the ball. We slid a couple times when we shouldn't have. Those are things that, again, an inexperienced defensive team like our team does once in a while. But if we can control just how we play mentally from here on out, especially at the defensive end, you know, we're going to get better.
Yeah. And now going back to last season, your teams have been involved in a lot of one-goal games, two-goal games that really haven't gone your way. What was the difference on Saturday?
You know, our resiliency, you know, we always talk about that phrase, who wants it more? And those want it more categories are the ground ball play, the face-offs, the ride, those hustle, physical type of situations in lacrosse that where you can demonstrate a little bit of heart, a little bit of effort. And I was really proud of our guys in the second half that we won those categories.
Yeah. And now last week we talked about the possible X factor being your attack against Drexel's defense. How do you feel that matchup went?
You know, I think they got the better of us overall. It was tough to dodge those guys. It was tough to get by them. They're a veteran unit, a senior group. And again, you know, Peter McMahon gets a couple and probably two of his biggest goals of his career, kind of like off ball. And I think one of the things that we did in the game that Brad Ross, you know, our offensive coordinator, we went to Alex Sommerfeld on the invert behind the goal. Mm-hmm. That was something we kind of went to in the second half, and we started generating some slides down to Alex where Alex could kick it up, make an extra pass, and you saw Peter McMahon generate some offense that way.
And finally, looking at this Drexel game as a whole, how would you grade your team's performance, A, B, C, D?
I give it an A plus in effort, heart, you know, desire, emotion. And I would say our execution was a C plus, B minus. We can play better. We can play better. But again, at the end of the day, as I say to our guys all the time, you know, old phrase I used in my youth, when in doubt, play football.
Yep.
You know, that means just play really hard.
Yep.
And I think that proved to be the factor for us last Saturday.
Well, again, it was a 7-6 win for the Bulldogs. It improves them to 3-2 on the season. When we come back from the Mike Pressler Show, we will have Jamison Love, the senior netminder of the Bulldogs. It's all coming up here next on Cox Sports Television.